Retailers estimate that shoplifting costs them as much as $47 billion per year. But some estimates say that illegal wage theft by employers costs them even more, at $50 billion. So why is one regularly featured here on the news while the other is not?
One former public defender argues the crime that hurts us most does not get enough attention. He joins us live, attorney and founder of Civil Rights Corps, Alec Karakatsanis. Good morning. You can hear us now, right?
Yes, I can. Thank you for having me.
Perfect. Thank you so much. So you suggest that the way we decide what crime is most important really needs to be reevaluated.
We were talking about, stolen goods, $47 billion. Wage theft, that's $50 billion, obviously more. So what are we ignoring here?
Well, the way that our society decides what to call crime is affected by things that have nothing to do with how much harm those things cause. So for example, it's illegal for poor people to wager in the streets over dice, but it's not illegal for wealthy people to wager over international currency. And then even within that, the kinds of things police choose to focus on are things that often have very little to do with what's harmful. So for example, a schoolyard fight in a poor neighborhood is treated as a crime that police enforce. But a fight at a wealthy school maybe is a trip to the principal's office. If you look at drugs, for example, it's virtually decriminalized to use drugs in wealthy universities and boarding schools, but heavily criminalized in poor communities across the country. The decisions about where to enforce what crimes are based largely on poverty. We have a system that jails people. 90% of the people in this system are very, very poor. And so at a high level, things like racial discrimination at work or sexual harassment at work or a lot of forms of environmental pollution, those are things that are treated as purely civil. But things that are treated as criminal by the police tend to be the kinds of things that poor people do. And that is true across the system.
Okay, so I mean, this actually relates to what we've been dealing mm-hmm. with here, not only in LA County, but I'd say the state of California. For months, we've been discussing a surge showing video of shoplifting in California. These mobs going into stores, taking clothes. We see it on surveillance cameras day in and day out. But you say that this news coverage, it's part of the problem. How so?
The news is focusing on a relatively small problem. So for example, the $47 billion figure you gave is a fabrication of the retail industry. Wage theft is actually about five times, by sort of scholarly estimates, about five times the problem of shoplifting. Wage theft is when large corporate employers steal money from their low-wage workers. That's a problem of over $50 billion a year. And these are the very poorest people in our society. If you think also about overdraft fees, fraudulent overdraft fees by banks cost tens of billions of dollars a year from the poorest people in our society. But yet there's not nightly news stories talking about every employer who is stealing the wage of their employee. Instead, you have a concerted effort by the retail industry lobbyists and their PR operations and the public relations departments of the police. Remember, in LA County alone, there are 67 people at LAPD and the LA Sheriff's Department who are working on information PR for the police. It's a very powerful force to wield against things like low-level shoplifting. And they don't choose to investigate the rampant wage theft in LA County. And that has to do with who's being harmed by it and who isn't.
All right, let's talk about homelessness, a major issue in many major cities, but illegal evictions, foreclosures are not often discussed. So aren't they, many people would say, isn't that a symptom of the issues causing homelessness?
Yeah, so this is another great example. You don't see a news crew outside the courtroom every single day a landlord is found to have illegally evicted someone from their home. You don't see a news crew covering all of the safety violations that employers are committing in LA County every single day, even though these illegal evictions and these employer safety violations are causing more harm, illness, suffering, and death than the crime that they are reporting on. We live in a society where 100,000 people in this country alone are dying from air pollution every single year. That's five times the number of homicides. And much of that air pollution is actually a result of crimes committed by large corporate polluters. We just have to reconceptualize our understanding of the things that are actually causing the most harm for us. If we genuinely care about safety, we would be diverting law enforcement resources to enforcing water pollution and air pollution laws. And instead, we have a situation where police are spending 96% of their time on what they call nonviolence. They only spend 4% of their time on the things that they call violence. And this means that they're doing rampant arrests for things like homelessness and trespassing and drug possession, and leaving hundreds of thousands of rape kits untested. We have a society where this is a public relations success for police and a safety disaster for everybody else.
Alec, if I could just really quickly, though, you don't live in Los Angeles, though. You're coming to us from the nation's capital, correct?
That's correct. This is actually not a problem limited to Los Angeles, although Los Angeles has seen pretty significant decline in overall criminal activity. It's historic lows in Los Angeles.
Well, I'm only asking because I'm almost certain that there are people watching right here, specifically in L.A. County, and I'm not really sure what it is that you're trying to say, because what I'm picking up is two wrongs don't make a right. It's obviously really bad to commit wage theft, but what we're seeing here in Los Angeles, and this is something we are seeing not every so often, this is every day. We are seeing people going into stores, they're looting. Just the other week in Beverly Hills, probably one of the most affluent areas in the country, we saw a man in a Ferrari and someone pistol whipped him to try to get his watch. This was unsuccessful. This was a failure. Should we not be covering that? And we should be covering other things. I just want to be clear what it is that you're calling for, because if someone is pistol whipped and their personal belongings are taken from them, or if people like teenagers are inside of a clothing store and groups of people go in there and they horrify the shoppers, they horrify the employees, I think we have an obligation to cover that, don't you think?
It depends on what you think your goal is as a news organization. Is your goal to cover the things that are causing the most harm, safety violations, threats to people's well-being? Or is your goal to sensationalize crime coverage and service of the police? For many, many years, this country has developed a system of mass incarceration. We are caging Black people at 6 times the rate of South Africa at the height of apartheid. We are spending hundreds of billions of dollars a year on policing interventions. And you know what? We still have a violent society. If more money on police made us safer, we would be the safest society in the world's history. So what I'm trying to do is analyze media coverage. Is the media covering things that are leading to the most death? Is the media covering things that are leading to the most suffering? And when you actually looked at the data, not the individual anecdotal stories, because for every anecdotal story of a pistol whipping that you tell me, which I care very much about, I am my whole career has been dedicated to safety and to the rights of survivors. But when you tell me that story, I tell you a similar story of a family who was being made homeless by a crime committed by a landlord, by an illegal fraudulent eviction. And I'm asking, why is it that local news in Los Angeles is not covering the crisis of fraudulent, unsafe housing for the poor? Why is it that the media in Los Angeles is not covering the crisis of environmental pollution by LA employers and corporations who are giving little kids cancer, who are killing older people who can't afford to leave point source pollution sites? These are the problems that are actually causing the most harm, suffering, and death for LA County. And they are benefiting the corporations that are profiting off of that activity, and they are benefiting the policing bureaucracy in Los Angeles, which is a multi-billion dollar fraudulent waste with crimes committed every single day, with fraudulent overtime, fraudulent sick leave by sheriff's department deputies and LAPD officers. These are the types of crimes that are never investigated, even though they are serious public corruption offenses. And that difference between the crimes that the local media highlights and the crimes that the local media ignores changes the perception that we all have about what is urgent and what isn't.
It's an important conversation. Alec, we hope to continue it sometime. Thanks for joining us from the nation's capital. For more, you can check out Alec's brand new book. It's called Usual Cruelty, or you can visit civilrightscorps.org. We'll be right back.